I'm going to test the best no-code AI app makers and find the best for you. And spoiler alert, there are different makers that can do different jobs better. For instance, some do a great job of UI and design, others give you great overall control, and others help you make an iOS app or Android app in minutes. Let's get started with Lovable. They claim to be Europe's fastest growing startup ever, and while many around the world might say Europe is not innovating very much, actually they are with this AI no-code tool, and it's a specialist in design. They've just launched Visual Edits. It's actually headed on Product Hunt, and you can not only create something amazing, but you can edit it visually without needing to re-prompt. Let me show you. So as a prompt here, I've said make an enhanced landing page for the Creator Magic community, use the CSS and the code that I've pasted in below, and also mention that a price increase is happening on the 1st of March 2025. Let's see what Lovable can create. Okay, here it goes. It's writing all the code for me right in front of my very eyes. And it's finished writing the code. Now it's spinning up the page. And look at this. Wow, this looks incredible. While it's kept similar themes, it's definitely made things look good. Okay, while this is cool, I can definitely see some bits I'd like to edit. And in order to dive in and do that, I can just click edit here. Now you'll see I get the ability to select any part of the page that Lovable made for me to change the design. So first of all, look at all these headers here. Now you can see they're black. They're not visually appealing against my dark background. Well, it's really easy to make a change. Now that I've selected all of those headers, I just click the color, and look at this, I get to choose what kind of color I'd like those titles to be. So I can literally change this without needing to re-prompt the AI. So I think I'm going to leave them nice and bright and white so they're readable. And that was done with a simple change. I just click save and the update is made. Same down here in the frequently asked questions, select my headlines here, color, and again, I'm going to make it that nice and readable. And that was all done very quickly, clicking save without needing to re-prompt or use credits from my Lovable account, I can make these visual edits. For those of you familiar with Figma, this should be a pretty familiar experience. Now, it doesn't stop there because I can also make text edits as well, like this headline here, Join Creator Magic Premium. Maybe I just want it to be Join Creator Magic. Well, just like this, I can delete premium, and now I can save that, and that is instantly updated on the landing page I made. And this works not just for landing pages, but for apps you're designing. Anything that you create with Lovable can be edited visually like this right now. You'll also see over here, you get a history of all the changes you made, which you can roll back, and you can also roll back what the AI did initially to create this page if you like. Now, it doesn't stop there. I want to make some high-level changes. Firstly, I'd like all these boxes to be equal in terms of length and width. So I've given a prompt here which gives clear instructions to the AI under the premium section, make the boxes same length and width. Okay, you can see here it says I'll help modify the feature boxes to have consistent dimensions. It's currently editing my code, and within moments I'll have an updated page. And boom, that didn't take long, and now all the boxes are consistent sizes. It looks really good. We've got what the members are saying here, and we've also got the frequently asked questions and a join now button at the bottom. All of this visually editable, by the way. Now, I did show you how to change colors, also how to edit text, but that's not all. You can do one more thing. I can select my feature boxes right here, and then I can choose to edit the padding. So I can make the padding smaller or larger like that, and I really can dial in my design. So say I want to make the padding 44 on each side, I can easily go ahead and do this, and now my boxes have a little more space around them. Now that I'm happy with these edits, I can switch off the edit mode. Note here, you've also got the attach option to attach pictures of websites. Lovable has a superpower in that it's visually amazing in the designs it makes. It can see stuff that you suggest, and now it can let you make edits without re-prompting, which I think is fantastic. Now, say I want to keep the code outside of Lovable, you have the ability to do that by clicking edit code and connecting to GitHub. Here, I'm going to select my account. And now we're connected, we can transfer the repository to my GitHub account. And it's as simple as that, it's done. Let's view on GitHub, and here is the repository from Lovable, all added to my GitHub account. You'll note here, it's a private repository as well, so this has not been made public. It even gives a wonderful README here, and I can then edit the code myself, put it into another editor if I wish, and even publish this page. Now remember, this feature is in early access. Click the link down below to go and try it out for yourself on Lovable. You can start with a free account, and let me know your your thoughts in the comments. If you're enjoying what you see so far, by the way, throw a like and subscribe to my channel as I do updates like this weekly. The next AI no-code tool I want to show you is Cursor. If you want overall control of your projects, this is brilliant, and they've introduced a new feature that I want to show you now. So I'm going to take what I created with Lovable and clone it from GitHub into Cursor. Now it's asking me, would I like to open the repo? And I can do that. And now you'll see everything I created in Lovable is now available to me in Cursor. Here are all the files. First, I'm going to hit Command I, and I'm going to go to the Composer and switch it to Agent Mode. This will mean it will do actions on my behalf to get this project working. And because I want to deploy this eventually to a web server, I'm going to say make this project run inside a Docker container so I can get it up and running on my web server. First of all, you can see the agent is listing what's in the directory. It's reading the JSON file here with the configuration. It's generating the code that's needed to make this Docker container. I just need to accept everything as it goes along. And here you'll see that Docker is going ahead and building the wonderful project here, and everything is going to be done in a matter of seconds. Boom. I have my Lovable landing page now dockerized and ready for deployment, created inside Cursor. That's why I say Cursor gives you great overall control. In fact, it's really my daily driver when I'm making no-code apps. But there's a cool feature that Cursor and actually many other no-code AI tools introduced this week, and I think it's given it superpowers. As discussed in the Creator Magic community, MCP, which is Model Context Protocol, turns it from a sort of sandboxed AI that just knows a few things about how to code to something that's connected to the web. You can now give your no-code app access to tools. For instance, making a pull request in GitHub is possible, searching for latest API docs using Perplexity, or even generating images via Flux. Adding a Model Context Protocol is easier than you think, and I'm just going to call it a tool, because that sounds better than an MCP, right? Okay, let's use this image generation MCP server, clone the repo into Cursor, open it, and I've said get this MCP server working using these docs with a link to the Cursor official docs and selecting agent mode. Given me a full step-by-step, so I copy the API token from my Replicate account. Now I just said, what do I need to enter into the Cursor settings to set up this running MCP server? And of course, it'll go straight through and give me everything I need to insert. Go back to my initial Cursor project, and this time I'll go into the cog in the top right, and I'll look in features, and I'll scroll down until I hit MCP servers. You'll see I've got none set up presently. Add a new one. The server name will be Replicate Flux Images, and we'll make it into a command, and the server command will be the one that was just provided by Cursor Composer. Click add, you'll see it goes green, which means it's active, and it has a tool available, which is generate image. So let's give it a go on my Creator Magic community landing page. Okay, you'll see not only is it going to work, but it knows exactly the right tool to call. It's asking to call an MCP tool, which of course is giving a prompt, the aspect ratio, everything that's needed to make images for my landing page, which is really cool. It is like superpowers, and you'll see here now, it's actually generating that image, and the images have been placed over here in my directory, and it wants to generate more images, so I'm not even going to look at the prompt, I'm just going to accept it, and you'll see more images appear over there. They're being created in real time. Now it's searching everything, and it's going to rewrite my landing page to include the images. With that all done, we can refresh this rather boring looking page, and we end up with, look, a Flux generated image in the background, looking rather cool and definitely making the landing page pop out more. That was all done with one single prompt, generating the image using a tool inside Cursor and integrating it into the code. Incredible stuff. And what's more, some magic seems to have happened because I seem to get different images in the background that fade between each other as I view this page. Look at that. That is a really cool touch that I wouldn't have thought of that Cursor did all by itself. Now, seeing as this was all created in a Git repo earlier on in Lovable, I can simply go back to my Git management, create a new update here, with AI, of course. Then I can commit and push it back to the repo. This will then mean when I access it, I can see the updates that were made now to the Git repo, meaning I can now clone this onto my server and deploy the web page. And now we go from something that looks like this, it's really rather static and boring, to something that looks like this, designed by Lovable to make everything pop out and look nice and have the right text, and then refined in Cursor using an MCP server for image generation. I think you'll agree, just a few extra touches to make this landing page look unique. Oh, and by the way, if you do want to join my Creator Magic community, this is your last chance to get a really good deal on the monthly price. You'll be locked in at the best available deal because I'm putting the prices up very soon, as described on the landing page I just created. So if you'd like to join in, use the link down below and I'll see you there. Oh yes, worth to note, if we go into the developer console here and go to mobile view, yes, it is even mobile responsive too, which is awesome. I didn't even ask for that in my design, but mobiles have been taken care of. Talking about mobile apps, let's move on to the final tool we're going to look at in this comparison. There is now presently a race to develop mobile apps with ease. You might remember the video I did a while ago about how easy it was to create an iOS app. Well, Replit are making it easier. And I've got a link down below if you want to join Replit or Cursor. So what is Replit? Well, it's got this excellent agent that can create apps, but now you can make mobile apps. And all you need to do is go to your Android or iOS device and download this app. Once you've got Expo Go running on your mobile, simply head into Replit and click Create App. Now you'll want to choose a template in this case, and you'll want to search for Expo. Once you've done that, you can give it a name, so I'll call it Wizard FX, like that. It's going to be private, and I'll click to create the app. Now, it'll throw you in here with the AI assistant to help you make your app, and it gives you a quick readme. To get this activated and initialized, I'll click Run. It actually gives you a QR code so you can access it on your mobile device too. Now, at the moment, if we click over to the web view, you'll see this is just a standard template that Expo have set up for you to work with in Replit. Now, I can actually access that on my mobile device as well by activating my camera like that and taking a quick shot. That is then going to take me over here, and guess what? Yes, you will see that will then take me to exactly the same app on my mobile as I have on my screen. So I can now use the assistant to alter this template and make my Wizard FX app. Now, before I write in my first prompt, it's important that you go to the settings here in Assistant and change the assistant prompt from default, and I need to add a new prompt, which I'll call Expo Project, and this will be the prompt here, and this is taken from the official Replit tutorial video, which again, I'll link down below. When I click Save, and then I choose that as my default prompt, Expo Project. Now Assistant is going to know that it's working with an Expo project and it won't get confused as I make my app. So let's try. Make me an app with many magical buttons on screen. When I press each different button, I get a different magical effect on the screen, from falling stars to lightning flashes, multicolor effects, and more. And it feels like it's done it, so I'll apply all. It'll restart my app. I got quite a few errors when I ran that, so I'm just going to paste those errors into Assistant and hopefully it's going to go ahead and fix them. Boom, in real time, it's fixed everything, it's restarting, and nice. Okay, we have three magical buttons that I can try on my screen, and I still seem to be getting errors on my screen and my mobile device. I'm asking Assistant to fix them, and I'm trying really hard. So again, pasting all those errors into the Replit Assistant and seeing if it can fix it and make me an app that works. Okay, it seems to have done something there. It's restarting my app on the screen here. And we do indeed have buttons that, yes, they work on the screen. They actually work. Look at that. So the question is, will they work on my iOS device? So you can see here, I still have the error, but I need to shake my device, which gives me the opportunity to then reload. And once it's reloaded, I can see some buttons there. They're kind of hidden down the bottom, but let's click them. And stars, yes. Lightning on my phone, and indeed rainbows on my phone. With a little bit of messing about, I got a half usable app, and I'm sure I could work more consistently with Replit Assistant and get something that's even better, add more buttons in, and really make this app into something incredible. So, what do I think? I think that Replit have done something amazing here, collaborating with Expo to allow you to seamlessly make apps that will work on both iOS and Android. They're solving this problem for us quickly. There is a little bit of clunkiness and back and forth, and errors pop up a lot in my experience, but this is the worst it's ever going to be, and creating apps is only going to get easier thanks to companies like Replit waving the flag for you to be able to do this with ease. Stars, lightning, rainbows, it's all possible now. Let me know how you get on with this down in the comments down below. So what are my final thoughts on all of these no-code AI builders that can make apps for you? I think Lovable is leading the race in good looks. It can make something that looks incredible, just like it did with my landing page. So if you want to make something that looks good and make little tweaks and alterations, change the text without having to reprompt, Lovable is going to be the place. They're also doing lots of integrations. They were very early with Superbase for back-end databases, and they've got Figma integrations and more. So if you want graphic design and ease of use, Lovable's going to be it. If you want full control and the ability to call different tools like I did to generate images and then insert them in the code of my landing page, Cursor is always going to win. And in fact, I still use Cursor every day to develop out all the ideas I have. It's a workhorse, but you've got to be a little more geeky and a little bit more into changing things. Although vibe coding, which is something I spoke about on last week's video, is a thing that's coming in very firm, which is the ability for you to speak what you want, click accept all, and see what comes up on the screen. So more and more people are doing that with Cursor. And finally, if you want to develop iOS and Android apps and do it all in one space and have ease of use, go ahead and check out Replit, which can also generate desktop and web apps as well. So it's a kind of all-in-one interface that's aiming to do everything you could ever want. And I think adding the ability to create these mobile apps is really cool. I did actually see this week as well, Bolt added the ability to do exactly this with Expo. I didn't get the chance to try it this week, but maybe you'll let me know how you get on with this and all the other things in the comments down below. And also find all the links to these apps that I compared, whether you want to use Lovable, Cursor, or Replit, all the links are down below. I would appreciate a like and a subscribe as I do these videos weekly, and enjoy creating with no code.